Officials at NASA have something new to worry about after their most trusted eye in space, the James Webb Telescope, was struck by an asteroid. But how bad is the hit? Will this $10 billion spyglass survive? And what does this mean for NASA's space exploration efforts? In today's video, we'll explore and explain everything you need to know about the recent accident with the James Webb Telescope. Launched aboard the Ariane 5 ECA rocket on the 25th of December 2021, the James Webb Telescope was designed to replace the aging Hubble Space Telescope. This phenomenal foldable telescope features 50 parts and 178 release mechanisms, giving NASA an unprecedented view of the cosmos. Due to the complexity of its unfolding process, the James Webb Telescope was never fully deployed until January 8, 2022. Weighing in at 6 tonnes, the James Webb Telescope is equipped with a 5-layer sun shield, 400-metre-long cables, as well as several gears, motors and springs. It has a diameter of 21 feet or 6.5 metres, making it the largest space telescope in history. In all, this incredible space optical machine consists of 18 hexagonal sections, all coated with an ultra-thin layer of gold to aid reflection. This ultimately allows scientists to travel back in time to 200 or 300 million years after the Big Bang to learn more about our universe and everything that occurred. Backed by some of the world's most innovative technologies, the Webb is able to view 40% of the sky from one position and 100% within 6 months, enabling cosmic scientists to see some of the farthest galaxies that seem beyond our reach. Clearly, this is one of the projects that NASA has high hopes for. After all, you don't invest $10 billion into a project and not stick into it the most sacred areas of your plans, right? As far as we know, the full deployment of the James Webb Telescope was seen as a huge milestone in NASA's space exploration plans. However, the excitement surrounding it and the incredible potential that it offers was threatened by an accident that happened recently. Sometime in May 2022, NASA's next generation telescope in space, the Webb, was hit by a tiny rock known as a micrometeoroid. Much like Earth, space is polluted by natural and artificial waste. This makes the environment incredibly dangerous to astronauts and space equipment. At the time of making this video, there are 150 million asteroids wandering in space. And when you talk about artificial waste, experts believe that there are approximately 34,000 chunks of debris with a diameter of 10 centimeters or above flying around up there. It gets even more dangerous when you consider that there are roughly 900,000 pieces of debris between 1 and 10 centimetres and over 128 million objects smaller than 1 centimetre hovering across space. In all, these junks are estimated to weigh 7 million kilograms. But these are not considered as high-level threats to telescopes. The main enemy of telescopes in space is micrometeoroids. Ironically, these elements are smaller than asteroids and meteoroids. Scientists describe them as being smaller than a grain of sand. However, their impact on telescopes can be devastating. For sure, any of them travelling at these neck-breaking speeds can run into any space machinery at any time. Nobody knows this more than NASA, hence they have prepared for the possibility of tiny space objects running into the James Webb Telescope. This is confirmed by an official statement by Paul Geffner, NASA's Technical Deputy Project Manager at Goddard Space Flight Center, who stated the following: "We always knew that Webb would have to weather the space environment, which includes harsh ultraviolet light and charged particles from the sun, cosmic rays from exotic sources in the galaxy, and occasional strikes by micrometeoroids within our solar system. We designed and built Webb with a performance margin, optical, thermal, electrical, mechanical, to ensure it can perform its ambitious science mission even after many years in space," he added. Actually, the mirrors of the James Webb Telescope are designed to withstand the impact of potential micrometeoroid strikes. In fact, trials were conducted before this spyglass was lofted into space to ascertain this fact. However, the space agency wasn't prepared for this level of catastrophe. analysis showed that the micrometeoroid that struck James Webb between the 23rd and 25th of May 2022 was bigger than anything NASA hauled at the equipment during the testing phase. Also, the incident was largely unexpected. Had the operators of the telescope got a hint of the impending disaster, they would have found a means to get the equipment out of harm's way. After all, nobody, including NASA or the European Space Agency, wants to incur a damage worth $10 billion. And that brings us to our next question. How bad was it hit? Well, certainly not fatal. But one of the 18 beryllium gold tiles that make up the mirror or reflector segment took the hit. As a result, a dimple was carved on the affected section called C3. This latest collision is the fifth collision between the telescope and a micrometeoroid. And this was confirmed by Lee Feinberg, the Webb Optical Telescope Element Manager at NASA Goddard. Since launch, we have had four smaller measurable micrometeoroid strikes that were consistent with expectations, and this one more recently that is larger than our degradation predictions assumed. NASA engineers have been able to correct the defect by adjusting the position of the affected segment to cancel out the distorted section. And thankfully, that's just about enough to get the James Webb Telescope back to normal. After initial assessments, the team found the telescope is still performing at a level that exceeds all mission requirements, Thomas Zurbeckan, the associate administrator at NASA's Science Mission Directorate, said in a tweet. Going forward, NASA will collect all the necessary information about this crash and utilize it to create an operational procedure to ensure that such a disaster does not repeat itself. We will use this flight data to update our analysis of performance over time and also develop operational approaches to assure we maximize the imaging performance of Webb to the best extent possible for many years to come, Lee Feinberg, the Webb Optical Telescope Element Manager at NASA, said. This news should bring a wide smile to the face of top NASA and European Space Agency officials who would have been worried about the fate of one of their most prized equipment. We should breathe a sigh of relief as well, because the James Webb Telescope is actually beneficial to all of us. Webb is expected to reveal the secrets and mysteries that cosmic scientists haven't been able to unravel so far, some of them dating back to around 13.5 billion years ago. It will also play a huge role in our quest to find another habitable planet. Currently, it's orbiting around the Lagrange 2 point, approximately 1.5 million kilometres away from Earth. First images from this mercurial optical eye will arrive on July 12, 2022, and scientists are already drooling in anticipation of what to expect. This was a close call. We came within inches of losing the most advanced space observatory machine ever built in human history. It's scary to imagine what would have been if the James Webb Telescope had been destroyed. NASA's space exploration would have been stalled, and our ability to explore the universe would have been limited. But thankfully, we got lucky this time.